Hello all, in this video I will discuss about normal forms in DBMS. So what is normalization? It is the process of decomposing unsatisfactory or bad relations by breaking up their attributes into smaller relations. So normal forms decided based on keys and FDs of a relation. So in my previous video I had discussed detailed about FDs or functional dependencies. So why we call something as bad relation? Bad relations are relations which allow you to enter redundant data. That means in a single table there is redundant data, repetition of same data. So what happens when you will try to insert, delete or modify this data, it can fetch some anomalies. So why normalization? First is eliminating redundancy. Second, organize data efficiently. Reduce the potential for data anomalies and quality and the properties of DBMS. Normalization is a good property of DBMS. Now what are the anomalies? Anomalies are the inconsistencies in the data stored in a database as a result of an operation such as update, insertion or deletion. So there are seven types of normal forms, but we discuss about first normal form, second and third normal forms and BCNF. So before starting with normalization, we need to know what is prime and what is non-prime attributes. So prime attributes must be a member of some candidate key, and non-prime attributes are not member of any of the candidate key in the relation. First normal form, it allows only atomic or single valued attributes. It does not allow any multi-valued attributes or repeating groups. So if you look at this example student table, it is having student ID, name, courses. Now if you look at name, it is a composite attribute here because name is having two parts, first name and second name. And courses, if you look at this attribute, it is also allowing multiple courses in a single column. So this is also a multi-valued attribute. So first what we can do, we can split the attribute name into two parts, first name and second name, how we have done here. And now these two columns will satisfy normal form. And what about courses? So courses is multi-valued attribute as I have already told you. So we should not allow this, or first normal form will not allow this. So what we can do, we can repeat this student one, student one again, and there is two courses registered by student one. So these two will become in two different rows. So now this table, the final table, is in 1NF, but you can see it is allowing some repeated data. So how to reduce that? For that we have to again go for further higher normal forms. What is second normal form? Any non-prime attributes A in R is fully functionally dependent on the primary key, and it does not allow any partial dependency. So there should not be any partial dependency. Now if you look at this example, student, course code, grade and course name, and there is a functional dependency. Student ID, course code together can identify grade and course name, but course code itself can't identify course name. So if we look at this, so we can say this is a partial functional dependency because whose name is identifiable by a partial part or one part of the candidate key. Okay, so this is a partial functional dependency. We will reduce this, so we can split this table into two part. First part is student course 1, which is having the attributes student ID, course code and grade. And another thing, based on this partial dependency, course code and course name be split into another table. Next is third normal form. If it is in 2NF, so first thing is that your existing relation must be in 2NF and no known prime attribute A in R is transitively dependent on the primary key. So what is transitively dependent? If X to Y and Y to Z, two functional dependencies are there, then we can say X to Z. So this is what we call as transitive functional dependency. But it will be allowed in only case that X is a primary key and Y is a candidate key of the relation, then it is not a problem for third normal form. But if Y is not a candidate key, then it will be treated as transitively functional dependency. Now look at this example. We have student ID, first name, second name, department ID, department name and department location, and you can see this is in 2NF. So we have a functional dependency, student ID to first name, second name and department ID, no problem. And another, department ID to department name and department location. Now this department ID department ID is not a candidate key for this table, right? So we can say we have a transitive functional dependency student ID to department name and department location, which violates the functional dependency, should not be there in the table. So we can split this table into two parts again. One is student, which is having student ID, first name, second name and department ID, and another table called department, department ID, department name and location. So in short, we can say first normal form, it's allow only attributes depends on the key, no composite or multivalued attributes will be allowed. 2NF, all attributes depends on the whole key or a primary key, but no partial dependency allowed. In 3NF, all attributes depend on nothing but the key. That means no transitive dependency is allowed. Every determinant is a candidate key. This is the bottom line for BCNF. If you look at this example, which is already in 3NF, but not in BCNF, we have student ID, course code, and teacher. Now, student ID and course code together can identify teacher, but again, teacher can identify course code, right? So now teacher is not a, what is called candidate key. So this is a something, this is these two functional dependencies together violating the condition for BCNF. So we have to split this table. So we have split it in two part, teacher and course and teacher and student ID. But some person may say that we have other option to split like student and course ID and teacher and course code like this, but that will violate the basic concept of normalization, that is after splitting a table into two part, if we join these two part back, we should get back the original table. Here if we join these two table, we should get back this table. So that will not allow. So we have to keep that in mind, and keeping that in mind, we have split it into these two tables. So thank you for watching. To get more videos like this, please subscribe this channel and like, share and comment on this video.